And CCTV's Martina Fuchs actually got a chance to speak exclusively to the chairman of the Dalian Wanda Group, who says the company plans to acquire two large overseas entertainment companies in 2015.
Dalian Wanda is today the world's second biggest real estate developer, but investors have voiced concern over its exposure to the real estate market here in China, as the company has been amassing a debt pile of around $29.2 billion over its decade-long expansion period. What do you reply to investors that are worried?
We 在这之前已经有招股说明书了，你看招股说明书可以看得很清楚。我们在没有募资之前，我们的净负债率只有44%的。如果再募这个40亿美元左右的话，40多亿美元，那么我们净负债率会降了40%以下，这个已经算是一个很安全的。
Only Wanda's property division is going public in Hong Kong, but the company also got for Wanda Film the approval from the CSRC for an A-share listing. When will the other Wanda divisions follow suit and go public?
这两个公司上市仅仅是我们一个部分了，其实我们在海外、在美国、香港还各有一家上市公司。将来我们当然主要的方向是要把我们发展成功的产业，有持续盈利的产业，陆陆续续都搞成上市公司，这肯定是一个目标。但也不意味着我们所有的都要变成上市公司，这个根据
Before the IPO, you had an estimated wealth of $13.2 billion, ranking number 4 according to the Forbes Rich List China. Now, after the IPO, you're believed to overtake again and reclaim your title from Alibaba's chairman, Jack Ma. What does this struggle over the first place mean to you?
对于财富的数量问题，我们从来就没有过任何的，去争或者去这个比较，这完全是媒体制造出来的一个话题，甚至有的还说是真，有的还说去抢，哎呦，我都觉得就是，我和小马哥我们俩都是一样的，只是觉得在自己的事业成功路上能够做得更好，能够把这事业做得更大，我倒没有过多的计较是不是要第一、第二还是第三，对吧？